They said the truth won't survive beside the lies that maintain the decaying faces of this place.
There's a lot of guys in the manosphere will talk about, because you know, you have a lot of men in the manosphere that will talk about she can't pair bond and so on, but in reality, it's not that. It's basically she knows she's so used to leaving a man, she cannot prioritize that this man is the only man. And that's what's happening. I mean, once a woman becomes a serial dater, her whole thought is, man, this is one man, there's another. There's always another. So she can't remain stable to another man. And then you got to know the laws. And here's the thing. And you know, you got to know something. Here's the thing. Even if she couldn't pair bond, if the laws were fair, because you've had that, you know, if you watch some old shows from the 60s or 40s or 50s, you had that wife that was a little more, you know, wild, you know what I'm saying? So she would get more creative with her husband and be more loose and wild because, you know, that's the type of spirit she is. So she would experiment far more with her husband or boyfriend, whatever, because she knew with the laws being what they are, that there isn't an advantage of authority where she could basically sic the family court on the man at any time. She would dedicate her time to that man. So even though she doesn't want to pair bond with him, she sees the laws and the stability that he brings. She has to get creative, you know what I'm saying, for that man and their relationship and so on. That's why you see a lot of films where, yeah, I don't really like him. She would say, you know, she don't like her husband and so on, but she stays with him, you know, because technically that's what it's supposed to be anyway. You don't need to love or like the person. It's all about stability. You know, the guys, you know, I know what he's gonna do. I know he's stable, respectful, so she stuck with him. But what you have in the danger of this thing is this. It won't really affect men as much. It's really gonna affect a lot more women psychologically, because there's such a short-term and short-term relationship cycle, super short-term, and it's about interaction. It means now women will actually be left out and be single sooner than later, because since there are multiple amounts of women that are participating in this super short-term and interaction, that man can leave her. So basically, you're gonna see a lot more women at age 25 to probably, I'd say about 25 to 25 to 26 being removed out of the whole dating scene sooner than later, sooner than like 28, 29, because the abundance of other women coming, you know, and participating in this, the younger ones coming to participate, 18 to 24, we're gonna have a lot more men say, well, you know, man, she probably been around the block, so I'm gonna be with this younger model. And the thing is, the curse of the internet is that your older pictures, your pictures of a woman when she was younger don't leave. You know, they're still there. You know, back in the day, before Facebook and so on, for a man to see a younger photo of a woman, he would have to go to her house or get to know her, you know, family photos and all that. Now, you scroll down her Facebook timeline 3 years ago, 4 years ago, you see the difference and you're like, damn, man, I could have had that version of her. Oh, I don't want the current version. Let me get another one. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it's become. And you got to look at it that a lot of women have become fast food, you know, fast food women. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of men, you know, you're not going to want a fried chicken that's been out and old and it's stale. You want the freshest piece of fried chicken as soon as possible. That chicken's so fresh. So fresh, you might end up biting a thumb. You know, you might bite a thumb off. That chicken is so fresh and fried, you know. And that actually could be a good chicken shack. Fresh and fried. Oh, that's somebody don't steal that. Fresh and fried. You know, where they fry everything. But basically that's what happens. You know, a lot of women, because we're in a interaction and super short-term relationship scenario and situation, because you gotta look at how mainstream Tinder became. Tinder became super mainstream around 2014 or so. Then it blew up, you know what I mean? And now you even have seeking arrangements where a man could basically look up a woman's price to be her sugar daddy, whatever you wanna call that. There's so many options for a man. And here's the other thing a lot of guys in the manosphere won't tell you. There's so many options for a man to actually avoid issues. You know what I'm saying? There's no point. What's happened is there's no point for a man to, you know, face a potential relationship where it's toxic and potentially leads to a domestic assault case. So men are literally moving around, you know, jumping and bouncing between relationships, you know, or interactions, because, yo, I don't need to settle. In fact, you know, you could jump on seeking arrangements and literally, you know, y'all got an arrangement. Or you could go to OnlyFans if you don't really want physical interaction. You just want potential to talk or some, you know, photos once in a while or whatever. There's so many options for men. You know what I'm saying? When it comes to it, and the thing what women don't get is with all these options, and then you put in, the thing is this, none of these options will be a problem if the law wasn't so biased between men and women. You know what I mean? But what happens is because the law is so biased, a lot of men are choosing alternative options. So seeking arrangements. You got Tinder for interactions and super short-term, you know, relationships. Then you have the bar scene. If you're going to the bar, well, somewhat, you're going to the bar or partying late night. You know what I mean? There's so many options. And what happens to women with all these options, it further exposes their age and their use. You know what I'm saying? So you know, you've been dating and serial dating from, let's say, 18 to 24, you know, serial date, you know, going on serial dates, serial interactions, super short-term relationships. You know what I mean? So let's say she's on a super short-term relationship every 2 to 3 weeks. That means by the end of the year, she's been with over, relationship-wise, over, you know, 10 men, and not adding up the men she's seen for interactions. So what you get is, you know, this type of scenario basically makes women, you know, I'd say they run out, their attraction will run out sooner than later. So I'd say about, I said 25 to 26, that's when a man will basically say, I'm good, I'll get another model. You know what I'm saying? And it basically makes women, I'd say in their early 30s, you're going to see far more women in their, let's say, 28 to 30 that are going to be single and out of the market. China has something for that. They call that leftover women. You know what I'm saying? So you're going to see a lot of them because of how much, you know, serial relationships and, you know, serial interactions we have between men and women. You know what I'm saying? Serial interactions for interactions and super short-term dates. You're going to end up with a scenario where you have far less women with men. You know what I'm saying? In a long-term relationship. And by long-term, I mean, let's just say 6 months to about a year. You know? So you're going to see a lot more women by the age of, I said, 26 to 30. I'll be out of the dating market, because what's gonna happen is this, just like you see this increasing female hypergamy with all the selection plus the laws on their side, you're gonna see the return of men that seek out fertility and attraction at the highest level. You know what I'm saying? So let's say 18 to 23, let's say 18 to 23, you're gonna see a lot of men just set up their tenders, they're seeking arrangements, their OnlyFans for about that age range. You know what I'm saying? So women over here, and it's happened overseas, you got China where, you know, where Korea become leftover women, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna have a lot of them, you know what I mean, a lot more men, basically, once they set their filter, cut off women at an age, like I said. So, you know, so you're gonna end up with the situation where men start a cutoff period for women sooner than later. So most likely a lot more guys are gonna set up their filters for, they, you know, they don't go beyond the age 26, you know, or 25. And you're gonna have a lot more women being single at a far sooner age. And in actuality, it's gonna actually return things to somewhat of what it was in the 1940s, 50s, where if a woman wasn't settling down sooner than later, she'd be out there alone and be doomed to be, you know, single for the rest of her life. You know what I'm saying? Because what's gonna happen with the filtering process is a lot of men are gonna start filtering the age point to about 18 to 25. So it's gonna leave a lot more women single because, you know, they chose to, you know, have a lot of interactions and super short relationships. And then, you know, with the open advertisement of, you know, praising body counts and all that, because what's happened is this, man. What's happened in today's over-sexualized society is that they've set women up to where, and it's preying on their instincts, but it's further pushing it based on the, you know, the corporate and, you know, and consumerism. Is what's happened is it's pushed the narrative that women do not have value unless they collect a lot of men. You know what I'm saying? As in, if she doesn't have a higher body count or a lot of men liking her inappropriately, give me a minute. What's happened is, if you gotta look at it kind of like Pokemon, you know, you got your Amber Roses. Amber Rose did some type of one night stand, an ad for a one night stand. This is a married woman and so on. You know what I'm saying? What's been implied is that women are basically playing stranger. They're playing, it's kind of like Pokemon. Gotta catch all the body counts you can. You know what I'm saying? As the more men you have under you, the more men orbiting around you, the more men you have as friends and so on, that's what determines your value. Not you having a stable partner, someone you could trust in your life. It's all about how many men you could have around you and how many men you could snap and have them come to basically tend to you or give you attention, you know. So that's what's happened, and a lot of women are being pushed towards that. But what's happens because of that is, man, it's kind of like that chicken analogy I said, is that you want the fried chicken that's stale, that's been left on the counter for over 5 hours, or you want the super freshly fried chicken, you know? So what's happened is a lot of men, they're going after freshly fried chicken because they're looking at it, it has less wear and tear, you know what I mean? It's not stale, it's gonna taste a lot better, you know what I mean? So what's happening is because we have a more body count society, you gotta have more bodies on you, more body counts, you know what I'm saying? Because of that, you're gonna have more men say, damn. No, you're gonna have more men say, damn, man, she 26, she probably been with over 30 men. I'm good. I'm gonna pass on that. Let's look, you know what I mean? 18, she was in high school, maybe, you know what I mean? She wasn't drinking out in parties, maybe. So you're gonna have a lot more men return to I mean, not exactly the standards of the 1940s, but you're gonna have men say, man, I only go beyond interaction and beyond super short-term relationships with somebody age 18 to about 25. Anything beyond that, that's just somebody I'll Netflix and chill with, or, you know, be on a super short-term relationship, you know, for about a week to probably a month before I ghost, you know, I get out of the relationship. So that's what you're going to have. You're going to have a lot of these, and it's going to become, I'd say by probably 2023, you know, 2023 to 2025, because of COVID, you know, you got to make sure, because of COVID-19, there was less interactions, or as I call it, a Conan-19. Because of Conan-19, and that's the other thing with Conan-19 is that, you know, women that were putting off long-term relationships and so on, you know, that were going up and down the neighborhood, you know, gotta catch all the bodies. Gotta catch them all. She wants to be the very best, like no thought ever was. Let me see. Like no thought ever was. To have men in her inbox is her test. To have simps is her cause. Thariman. Oh, it's between her and many. Her goal is to get them all. She'll sleep with you. She'll sleep with him. Thariman. She's gotta catch them all. Gotta catch them all. Yeah, my bad. But, you know, that's what's gonna happen. What's gonna happen is a lot. And then you gotta look at the wear and tear from all the late night partying, drinking, the chemicals of makeup. You know what I'm saying? I've seen some chicks at 25 that look like they're damn near 30. You know, 35. They don't allow their bodies to rest, and they don't understand that their bodies can't hold as much alcohol as men. Their bodies aren't designed to be abused like that. You know what I mean? Without consequence. So what you have is you're going to have a lot more men. And, you know, they're going to filter it. Like I said, you got your tenders, you got seeking arrangements, you got your OnlyFans, all these options to get a more fertile, you know, woman in her youth. And what's going to happen to the women that get older is they're basically going to exit out the dating market sooner than later. And, you know, for some, even sooner, because, you know, age, here's the thing. Age is nothing but a number when it comes to your expiration date. You know what I'm saying? The expiration of your attraction and fertility. She could be 21, but because she's drunk herself to death, you know, drunk and destroyed her body, she could be out of the market. That's where age is nothing but a number. You know what I mean? Age is nothing but a number, because she could be obese. You could expire sooner then later. Your attraction could expire. You know what I'm saying? And fertility. So what you're going to have with this interaction and super short-term relationship scenario is that you're going to have a lot more women by, I'd say, about 26 and up removed from the dating market, you know, and a lot more men saying, damn, man. And I plan to make a video on explaining further on why I think what's gonna happen is men are gonna have the cutoff point. Men are gonna pretty soon have the cutoff point be, I'd say, probably 23. After 23, it's done. Because, and I'll explain further on another video, but it's gonna have to do with her experience as an adult, you know, her drinking experience. I'll go into that, but all I can say is we're gonna have, and we already have it, it's an interaction and super short-term relationship market. You know what I'm saying? Because you have Tinder, she could look up a new guy ASAP and he could look up a new girl ASAP, and him knowing how the laws work and knowing that, you know, I mean, right now, I mean, if you go talk to a chick and you tell her your feelings and you tell her, I want to be an item, you know, I don't want, you know, it's either we're an item or nothing. She could say, well, you know, he pressured me into being only with him. You know what I'm saying? That's in the back of many men's heads now. You know what I'm saying? With the laws being what they are and with how much men are being targeted and told they're trash 24/7. Gillette ads, they even sneak them in ads and all that. Films, you know, roles that would be for men, you see, you know, there's a lot of things happening. So to me, what you're going to see is, man, this is the future now. Unless, and here's the thing, there's no going back, because here's the thing, women will not fight to change the laws, you know, because women are stuck in a loop. The young women are stuck in a loop. They're, you know, unlike men where, yo, man, you know, your pops will be like, yo, man, when I was your age, you know what I mean? I don't want you to do that. You know what I mean? So I changed the laws. I don't want you to end up the way I end up. What happens with women is that, you know, all the laws benefit younger women. You know what I'm saying? So the younger women will want their turn. They'll want their turn to, you know, use and abuse the laws. So that's what you're going to end up with. They're stuck in a loop where the laws will never change, because the younger women want their turn. And when the younger women are too old to, you know, maximize their attraction, then they get to yell and curse out men. You know what I'm saying? The cycle continues, you know, and the older women will try to shame men to dating older women. You know what I'm saying? When they're younger, what happens is she got a pick of the men she wants. You know what I'm saying? So when she gets older, and it's going to be a backhand attack, because a lot of the older women are really attacking the younger women. When an older woman says, why are you dating a girl that's 18, 21, 22? She's basically saying that that younger woman doesn't deserve a stable man that can protect and provide for her. That's what she's saying. You know what I'm saying? But the way they do it, because women tend to be more passive aggressive, you know, they center the attack at the man. But in reality, they're saying out loud that the younger, fertile women that they can't compete with don't deserve a stable man. Because you become an adult male at 18, you know what I'm saying? And then, you know, 18. So forget looking at the man's age. She's 18. Let's say that man is 40. She's an adult. 18, 40. You're an adult as soon as you turn 18. So what you have is the women have, the older they get, they'll have backhand attacks at younger women. Because when she says, when they try to shame a man by saying, oh, why are you dating a woman younger? They're basically shaming and attacking younger women by saying, you don't deserve a man that's stable and can provide for you because you're of this age. I should get them. You know what I'm saying? They're using shame to try to maintain and force a man to accept their, when the fertility window's gone. You know what I'm saying? Or the attraction is gone. And to limit the man's, you know, settlement. You know, what he's settling for. You know what I mean? And they're stuck in that loop. Every young woman, let's say 18 to 25, will have an opportunity to participate and take advantage of the laws. So a lot of them are stuck on a loop. The laws will never change. And, you know, I plan to make a video on why the laws not only will never change, but shouldn't change. And why, in reality, we're heading towards something that will probably end man's ultimate weakness. And that's the inability to breed without assistance, you know what I'm saying, from an opposite sex. You know, we're heading to that, but I don't want to make this video super long. So, you know, that's where we're at, guys. You know, we're in the interaction and super short-term relationship market. And, you know, maybe I might do this video over another time. But basically, that's where we're at. And that's what's going to happen. It's going to continue to happen. Because the government actually wants this to happen. And corporations actually want this to happen, you know. But, you know, this has been Hold the Truth Hostage, where if the truth was so important, we wouldn't negotiate with lies. Peace.
They said the truth won't survive beside the lies that maintain the decaying faces of